All right, Tommy's already left me, but I'm gonna try this really steep part. I think I should. Okay, let's try this out and see what we think. Oh, I ran out of gas. I did.
Hey everybody, I've got a fun one for you today because we are going off-road, but we're going off-road in classic style with David's truck. David has been the mastermind behind the TFL Tumbleweed Ranch off-road course, and we're gonna get your truck nice and dirty today.
We are. Well, I've been using it for hauling rocks, hauling logs, you know, whatever I'm doing down in Andre's pit. Between this and my Cummins truck, these are my two go-to trucks. I especially love this one though.
Okay.
This is like my favorite truck right now.
Now David, this truck has something called the G80. Can you explain what that is?
Well, I don't know exactly how it works. It's a series of like little clutches inside there.
Well, nobody knows exactly how
it works. It's like magical.
It's just like
something inside there like catches and makes both tires spin at the same time.
It's a locking differential.
I've never taken one apart.
Nobody has.
Yeah.
Yeah, the engineer who made it is probably dead, and now it's just a mystery.
I do know they wear out.
Oh, they do?
They do, yeah.
But it's not like a typical clutch LSD, right? Like, it's a permanent engagement when it locks.
Yeah, once it locks, it's engaged until you let up on it. I don't know.
Maybe there'll be a wizard in the comment section that can explain
it. Somebody tell us how the G80 works, because I don't really know.
Well, we're just going to see if this one still works.
It may or may not. I have no idea. I've never tested it. I mean, to see if it works. So today's going to be a good test for it.
So we're going to start with our obstacle that we have named trenches. And basically what this is are these gnarly divots in the earth that is going to really get the vehicle articulated and stuck. And my dad said you took a Hyundai Santa Cruiser here earlier today and it didn't make it.
It failed this test.
Wow, that's surprising. Now, a vehicle with open diffs I think would fail horribly at this.
Yeah.
So this is going to be the ultimate test of the G80.
It'll tell if our G80's clutches still work. All right, we're going down in the dip. We're leaning sideways. We're in first gear.
Hopefully we don't test the roof strength capability of the 92. Yeah.
Okay, we're coming out.
Okay, we're stuck.
We're spinning. See if the G80 kicks.
I'm expecting this to
It's not doing anything.
Slam me in the back, David. Oh no!
Huh? Gonna be like the Santa Fe. Maybe I try a little momentum. Let's try momentum.
When in doubt, cheat.
Okay, second gear this time, okay? Not first gear. Oh, that got us through the first one.
There you go. Nice work. All right, now for the second one.
Oh, it kicked.
Oh, there it goes.
It did. It kicked in. I felt it. There it went again. There it went again.
You fixed it.
I don't know if it needed more wheel spin.
Yeah.
You think?
Well, that little magic box back there, I've been told so many different things by so many different people. I mean, the one I often hear is it's based on a differential in speed between the wheels.
Okay.
But it almost feels like, at least in these older trucks, it's based on like not only rotations, but how much torque is being applied to it. Does that make sense?
Maybe
it feels like when you really start pushing the throttle.
Right. And maybe it's wheel spin. Maybe it's actual centrifugal force.
Maybe. Someone's got to know.
Somebody tell us.
All right, David, so we got some nice stuff going on here. Talk about the wheels and the tires.
Well, it's the standard wheel, steel wheel, but I paint them black and then I put a little beauty ring on there.
Clean them up a little.
And of course I run Michelins.
Yeah, you're a big Michelin guy.
Yeah.
And then I do have a couple questions.
Okay.
Government truck.
Yeah.
Why does it say Frontier? Is this the airline? Is this a company?
I think that was maybe the company that sold the flatbed. Because the flatbed, here, come back here. It's a Napheed.
Okay.
Is that
yep.
right? And it supports your local wildlife officer. And then I think Frontier was the company that maybe sold it. All right, Tommy, so when I dug these holes, I didn't think they were deep enough. So I came back the other day and I dug a few a little deeper.
Okay.
But we'll see if the G80 kicks in here.
Well, and we'll see how the ride is too over the holes.
So. In the trenches, I was in first gear.
Yep.
And it never kicked in.
All right, well, we're gonna dive down into this hole.
I'm back in first gear.
Oh, look at the ground clearance.
Oh yeah.
No problem in the old Chevy, David.
Right? It's good though, doesn't it?
Sorry, GMC. Professional grade.
GMC. Oh, that's nothing.
That was a good ride too.
Oh yeah.
You want to do the ultimate test of ride? Should we try logs?
All right, let's do logs.
Did you put the 454 on the valve cover? That seems pretty sporty.
It came that way.
Wow.
It's a Tonawanda engine made in Tonawanda, New York.
Is this throttle body, David, or port injected?
Yeah, throttle body. That's what I like about these years. Super simple, just two injectors, kind of like a carburetor. The injector's just right into the intake, and they're easy to replace.
Is there an O2 sensor?
Yeah.
Yeah? Uh-huh. Okay. Yeah.
Has one O2 sensor.
One.
Yeah.
Wow.
And, they're simple. That's me. If you didn't know that already, Tommy, I like simple, right?
When you put 300,000 miles on one of these engines, what is like the first thing that fails, or are they pretty good?
Probably the first thing that failed on my other one was a clutch.
Okay.
Because I use it as a work truck. I think I went through, it's on its third clutch. I don't know about this one. So this one from the guy I bought it from, it had 100,000 miles on it.
Okay.
So the Department of Wildlife didn't use it that much. It was probably like hook a horse trailer up and, you know, go get some cattle that are lost somewhere. I don't know exactly. So it didn't have a lot of miles. But I this one could go, if it could go like my other one, it could go for another 200,000. This could be the last truck I ever buy right here. I love you guys' comments when you comment about what we do, because I do learn from it. And you guys are saying, oh man, that's like, I could take my mom's Crown Vic over that. But I kind of took offense to it, so I made it a little more difficult.
All right, let's see how the ride quality is. Independent front suspension.
We're gonna crawl. I'm gonna leave it in first gear, and I'm not gonna feather the clutch at all. We're just going for it.
Yeah, last time I was out here, David's like, you drive too slow, take it up 30. And now he's like, Mr. Crawl, I see, when it's your truck, you wanna crawl it. It is pretty comfy though.
It is.
It's less comfy at the top.
We're definitely going for a ride here. Oh yeah, that was nothing, man.
No clutch though.
No clutch on that. But that was crawl gear.
That was good.
Yeah.
Man, this thing's just eating it all up.
What next?
Rocks.
Rocks.
What we've got back here is kind of a funky setup, and I have a lot of questions about why your winch is on the butt of the truck.
Okay, well, a few days ago we got your Jeep stuck down in the pit,
yes,
right?
Yes.
And so we tried to use my winch, and we pulled the cable out, we put it on the mule, and I haven't wrapped the cable back up on the winch.
Okay.
So people wonder, well, why is it on the back? Well, I made this truck capable of either carrying it on the front or the back or in the bed. And I've got this so that I can put, or you could take the darn thing off completely and hook it up to a tree and pull yourself out sideways if you wanted to.
Is it your skid plates?
It's got a front skid plate, but the drive shaft's exposed.
Sure.
Like most pickups.
What about the fuel tank?
Fuel tank's got a plastic skid plate on it.
It's got plastic on.
All right, I'll do the same thing. I'll be first gear, crawl, no clutch, okay?
All right, give it a go. Feels pretty good. Now keep in mind, this was an HD, or the equivalent of an HD truck back in the day.
Yeah.
So in theory, a 1500 would have a better ride even. See if you have the traction up here at the top, if we're gonna bottom it out.
Ooh. Almost. I heard a little ting.
A little ting down there. Hey, though, we did it. All right, you wanna try mounds or volcano next?
Let's do volcano.
All right.
A little more. Okay.
Sweet! So how much do you think the setup cost you?
I think the winch at the time was around $300, and then I had most of the steel laying around. You can buy, you know, 2-inch tubing to fit in a receiver, this quarter wall. And then I welded some supports underneath it. Nice thing is I made it a little bit aerodynamic, so when I have it on the front, it pushes the wind around the truck.
Yeah, it's like a Tesla.
But it is heavy. So.
Yes.
Very heavy.
But the cool thing about it is, I mean, you're probably under $500 if you wanted to do this.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pretty good.
Yeah. Well, even with, I mean, I spent a lot of money for this good cable too.
Yep.
But the versatility is pretty handy.
Cool.
Let's go ahead and unhook that.
Before we start a fire in your bed.
All right. Go ahead and take this puppy at an angle. We'll try to get her nice and stuck.
Okay.
For the fine folks watching.
We'll see if the G80 will kick in.
Yep. Oh, right there it is.
Right there. Yeah, baby.
So you gotta kind of commit to the throttle. It seems.
That's
like.
It.
Yeah.
I gotta have a little wheel spin.
It's not very refined, but it does get you where you need to go. It's better than an open diff.
I bet if we go back and look at the volcano, it's got a big divot in it.
These are the course destroyers.
Right.
G80. All right, you want to try the last one, Mounds?
Okay.
See if we get high-centered.
Yeah, that one's one I'm a little worried about.
Are you?
Well, my drive line's right there, right? But.
Well, you don't have to go over it if you don't want to. This is an appreciating asset, David. This is a collectible item.
Now. I say what we do, Tommy.
Yeah?
We go to the harder course. We go through the mud pit. What I'd really like to do is take it, not through the one we got the Jeep stuck, but I want to see if I can climb that hill.
Okay.
That we took the mule through.
Sounds good. Let me go grab the side-by-side.
Okay.
And meet you over
All
there.
Right. I'll go second gear so I can get a little wheel spin. No problem. I think the mud pit, it's not like your other mud pits where it's bottomless. I think there's rock down in the bottom of it, is what I think. So my guess is if you're any bit capable, you'll probably make it through there fine. Hey, Tommy! All right, Tommy's already left me, but I'm gonna try this really steep part. I think I should. Okay, let's try this out and see. Oh, I ran out of gas. I did. Oh no. My winch is about ready to run out the back. Shoot. This is a predicament. About to lose my winch and I'm about at a 40 degree angle. Hope my emergency brake works. I got sidetracked over here, Tommy. I thought you were going ahead. I thought, well, I'm going to try and climb this one. And I only have like an eighth of a tank in there right now. And I got at that angle and it just like quit. And then my winch started rolling out of the back. And all my chains and everything came out the back.
Oh, man.
So I better put these in the front seat.
Well, yeah, we can also put it in the wheel. We have yet to have a successful trip in the back of a... the fish pond section here in Tumbleweed Ranch. The first time, I got my Jeep hopelessly stuck. Now David's on like a 45 degree still hill. Out of gas.
I need my inclinometer.
You also bent your license plate. David, if your brakes fail backing it up, you are literally going for a swim. David's theory right? Is it gonna start right back up or is it gonna be broken?
Alright, let's find out if it starts.
Hey!
It just doesn't like a 45 degree angle with an eighth of a tank.
That's some useful consumer advice right there. So okay. We've proven the mighty GMC has conquered Andre's pit. Next week we'll come back out and we'll try the hard side.
I agree. We ought to do it and we'll bring the winch along just in case we get stuck.
Maybe some gas.
And some gas. Okay.
Alright guys, thank you for watching this episode of TFL Classic. As always, stay tuned for more shenanigans in Steven's fully filled GMC.
Thanks guys.